The United States government is well known for conducting a wide variety of strange research experiments. Many of these are described as being on the cutting edge of scientific advancement, and this has led to incredible breakthroughs in medicine, computer technology, agriculture, and a wide variety of additional fields used across the military. However, oddly enough, there seems to be a recently declassified government experiment that was approved for release back in 2003, surrounding the training of psychic soldiers and enhancements to the brain known as the Gateway Process Experience Experiments. The declassified document, titled Analysis and Assessment of Gateway Process, seems to be a written memo between a United States Army researcher at the CIA and sent to a US Army operational commander located out of Fort Meade. The subject of the memo seems to have been the analysis surrounding the legitimacy of the Gateway Process study, as the researcher writes the following in an opening statement. You tasked me to provide an assessment of the Gateway experience in terms of its mechanics and ultimate practicality. Most likely, the United States government was unaware of what the Gateway process really entailed, and so sent an independent researcher to the experimentation areas to undergo the process and learn if there was any legitimacy to the study in the first place for continued funding. However, within the first paragraph of the document, the researcher makes a special note to include that the Gateway process was a technique designed by Itzhak Bentov, stating the following. Based on conversations with a physician who took the Gateway training with me, I had recourse to the biomedical models developed by Itzhak Bentov to obtain information concerning the physical aspects of the process. For those that are not aware, Itzhak Bentov was a leading Israeli researcher, known for his incredible contributions in the creation of patents for the steerable heart catheter, ECG electrodes, pacemaker leads, and a number of other patents that would help to form the Boston Scientific Meditech Corporation. Itzhak Bentov was also known for his contributions to the Israeli Defense Force, being one of the lead inventors on the Israeli missile project, as well as many other improvised weapons. What many are not aware of surrounding the Israeli inventor was his devout belief and following in the mystical side of consciousness, which would lead to his primary contributions to the Gateway Process experiment. John Abel, Bentov's fellow business partner, was once quoted as saying the following. I was interested in how the brain worked and actually attached electrodes to his head, which were connected to a function generator in which he could change the wave shape and the power and learned about how the brain interprets these different frequencies. The document then goes into the breakdown of what the Gateway process holds, with the first explanation from the researcher being in regards to the human body's natural frequencies of the brain and the frequency following response. According to the study, a form of enlightenment can be triggered in a person's mind when both hemispheres of the brain begin operating at the same frequency, allowing them to communicate without any form of distraction and leading to a heightened state of focus. Although it requires a number of different techniques to reach this state, the main contributing factor in the study was a device that relied on the human body's natural frequency response. In the document, the researcher details the following statement. To achieve synchronization of brain hemispheres, the hemisync technique takes advantage of a phenomenon known as the frequency following response, which means that if a subject hears a sound produced at a frequency which emulates one of those associated with the operation of the human brain, the brain will try to mimic the same frequency pattern by adjusting its brainwave output. Therefore, if the subject is in a fully awake state but hears sound frequencies which approximates brainwave output at the theta level, the subject's brain will endeavor to alter its brainwave pattern from the normal beta to the theta level. Additional techniques for reaching a syncing of the hemispheres include assisted hypnosis from a psychologist, as well as techniques that match transcendental meditation practices, with a note stating that gurus who have practiced transcendental meditation practices for 20 years have the ability to reach a hemisphere sync for up to 15 minutes at a time without any form of assistance technologically. According to the document, this training lasts about 7 days before a person is capable of reaching a hemisphere sync frequency with the assistance of technology and is capable of furthering the study with tasks related to skill in the Gateway process experience techniques. The first task that is given to the trained subject is that of problem solving. When under the influence of synced hemispheres, a subject can call upon its higher self for assistance in solving problems, with the higher self representing a form of unfiltered subconscious that can remember everything ever taught to the subject and use it for perfect creativity and logical deduction. The document details that this ability can be used to solve personal difficulties, technical problems in the realm of physics, mathematics, science, practical administrative problems, and so on. In a way, turning the brain into an instantly responding and calculating computer that can analyze and process information at a much faster rate than normal. The second task that is given to the trained subject is referred to as an energy bar tool. The subject is then required to visualize and focus different forms of energy throughout its body, being fed by the universe to allow the body to undergo rapid healing processes. This could mean that with increased focus on the mind, the brain can suddenly consciousness force autonomous physical processes, such as healing and heart rate, with ease. The third, and usually described as the final task for most of the subjects, is referred to by the researchers of the gateway process experience as remote viewing, although is not similar to traditional remote viewing noted by psychics, to see distant locations using astral projection. Instead, the technique requires the subject to visualize and access parts of their memory, and begin to holographically portray the memory in such a way as to allow the person to relive memories with perfect total recall. The researcher writing the document then notes that this is typically where the training and ability of most of the subjects end up, and that less than 5% of the participants are able to move past these skills into the realm of impossible to understand psychic abilities. The document then details the following. The ability known as Focus 21, the future. The last and most advanced of all the focus states associated with the Gateway training program involves movement outside of the boundaries of time-space, as in Focus 15, but with attention to discovering the future rather than the past. The individual who has achieved this state has reached a truly advanced level. The research document then goes on to state that the ability to travel into the future is accomplished only after a subject is able to master an out-of-body experience. This occurs when the natural brain frequency of the hemispheres are synced and then reach a matching frequency with the background electromagnetic phenomenon of the universe, allowing consciousness to imprint itself and begin to leave its body and journey out into the rest of the world. Picking up electromagnetic information similar to how a radio captures radio waves and how our eyes capture photons to imprint an image of our surrounding environment. Once this information begins to pour into the consciousness of a person, they can then begin the process of astral projection that will allow them to speed up time and look into the future, as well as deep within the past at moments that their memory would not be able to access. There is a sound, rational basis in terms of physical science parameters for considering the gateway process experience to be plausible in terms of its essential objectives of heightened brain activity. Additionally, the document seems to hold several pages involving a new scientific theory as to the formation of the universe as a massive three-dimensional toroid, helping to explain why certain parts of the universe seem to be moving at faster speeds compared to others, as evidence of this donut shape moving the mass of galaxies back down and around to the other side of the universe. The document then ends with the researcher stating that the gateway process experience should be provided to all members of the organization for heightened mental ability, and goes on to suggest a 12-step plan as to how to provide the gateway training to all members of the organization. The memo then states that the training could open up members of the gateway process to be attacked by intelligent energy beings if the boundaries of time and space are continually surpassed. The document states the following. Subjects must be intellectually prepared to react to possible encounters with intelligent, non-corporeal energy forms when time-space boundaries are exceeded. With additional statements that perhaps practical use of the gateway process experience could be used to gather information from such entities and the universal consciousness. So, what do you make of this interesting document? Be sure to leave your questions and answers in the comments section below and help us to grow this community while working to solve these unexplained mysteries. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos.